everybody, welcome back to Jazzy Green Decor Style. Today I have a tag that I saw last year in 2019, but I wanted to do it this year because I was on vacation, and it's called the Goodbye 2019 Tag End of the Year. I first saw this tag on Tashonda Renee's channel, and I'll have her channel in my description box in case you want to just take a look at her channel and look at her tag as well. But I just thought it would be a nice, fun tag because, you know, you guys, you know I love doing tags, so, and welcome. So I decided to go ahead and do it, even though it's after 2019, and that's okay, I can still do it. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started with these 10 questions. I just thought it would be nice and fun. Number one, your happiest moment of 2019. Wow, my happiest moment of 2019. I have more than one, but I'll just share the one that's the most dear to me, and that's the fact that I decided to start losing weight, and I saw the weight coming off of my body and everything leaning up and toning up. So that would have to be the happiest moment. Number two, the saddest moment of 2019. That was when my daddy had got really, really sick, came very close to death, and he almost died. So, and that would have been, if he had died, that would have been on Father's Day. So that would have been, I call, the saddest moment of 2019. Number three, what did you learn this year? What did I learn? I learned a lot of things. Life is precious, and we take advantage of life. The fact that I started making healthy choices and changes to my lifestyle, my health, that was crucial to me. That was very important. So I learned that taking care of your body is very important. Now, I've always known that, but I guess I didn't really take it very seriously until I ended up in the ER. So I would have to say making healthier changes to my health and lifestyle. Number four, did this year go by fast for you? You know, every year seems to go by fast. It really does. But I'm going to say yes, it did. Number five, what foods are you cooking or eating on New Year's Eve? Well, the fact that this is after New Year's Eve, what did I eat? I didn't cook anything special. We all just ate what we ate. I had boring, healthy salad. And I shouldn't say boring, but, you know, to most people it would be considered boring, but it was a healthy salad, which I enjoyed with my pistachio nuts. And what else did I have? I had a small little bowl of some red beans with some cabbage that I cooked, and it was delicious. So that's what I cooked for myself. Number six, have you picked out your outfit for New Year's Eve? I sure did. And that was my lounging pants and the top, the shirt, this shirt here, but it was a gray one that I had and that I got for Christmas. It's a dark gray, so it was just like this one, and you're seeing it now, but in a gray. So that's what I had picked out. I wasn't going anywhere special, so I just said, let me put on my lounging clothes because it's just safer being at home, and I just wanted to be comfy. So I was very comfortable. Okay, number seven. What are you going to do on New Year's Eve? Well, we stay home. It's just safer being at home, you guys. Yes, it would be nice to go out somewhere, but it's just safer being at home because I don't want to be around any drunk drivers, any craziness. And I figure if you don't really have to go out, why go out? Just stay home. And if we did go out, we would hopefully stay over at someone's house because I don't like to be in the street, you know, during those difficult, those moments, you know, where people are celebrating, being crazy. So it's just better being at home. Okay, number 8. What was your proudest moment this year? My proudest moment this year was the fact that I lost so much weight. I'm sorry to have to bring that up, but that's a big deal to me. I've been struggling with this for decades, okay? So I deserve to be happy. I deserve to feel good. And this was really, it truly was the proudest moment. And I'm still going, so I'm very proud of myself. All right, 2 more and we are done. Number 9, what will you do different this year? I didn't really think about that one too much. What will I do different this year? I'm just gonna make it simple. I'm gonna start improving in every area of my life that I did not do last year. Try to work on goals and get them to come to pass this year than I did last year. You know, just kind of tweak a little bit here and there. And just make 2020 the best year I can, you know, improve where I can, love more, forgive more. I mean, we're all supposed to be forgiving one another. So, you know, I'll do anything positive that I can this year to make a great impact on my life. And last and final question, number 10, what are your New Year's resolutions? Well, that's an easy one. I don't celebrate resolutions. I don't make resolutions. I don't believe in the word resolution. I believe in setting goals, writing the vision for your life. Now, I have written out my vision for 2020. I have a list of things that I expect to come to pass that I will be working on. You know, that's my desire, and I still have some more things to write down on the list. So I will be working hard, doing things to help bring that change, you know, help it to come to pass. Not resolutions, because resolutions, that's just temporary, you guys. People say, oh, I'm going to start losing weight, start my diet on Monday, and then by Friday they've ended it. That's a resolution. So I like setting goals and realistic goals. So anyway, this was a fun tag. I had to jump in on it, and I know that it's after 2019. That's okay. This still is the new year, so I was happy to do it. So if you guys would like to join me in this tag, just feel free. I'm not tagging anyone this time. I will put the questions down in my description box, so go ahead and copy and paste them. So anyway, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this tag. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm so glad to be back starting the new year strong. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you later. Bye.